Even when it is presented like this, ruthlessly stripped down to its last nut and bolt, you will, of course, have recognised that this is the seminal 1959 Suffolk Colt 12-inch four-stroke petrol lawnmower. The people's lawnmower. The lawnmower that revolutionised the idea of popular grass cutting. And it is fashionable these days to deconstruct history. But that's not what we're going to do here. We are going to put history back together again. I have as long as it takes to reassemble this beast from a pile of 331 lawnmowery type bits. And to help me, I have a 50-year-old owner's manual and some tea. Right, we'll start with the engine because that's what makes this a petrol lawnmower. If it didn't have a petrol engine, it would merely be a lawnmower. The first bits to go into the engine are the valves that control the flow of fuel and exhaust gases in and out of the cylinder. This might be a good time to tell you a little bit about the history of the lawnmower, which was invented by Edwin Beard Budding in 1830. He was actually inspired by a machine that removed the pilling, or whatever you call it, from fabric at a factory that made uniforms for army officers, I think. And he saw that and thought, if I make it a bit bigger, it would cut the grass in a very neat, uniform way. A lot of people thought Budding was a lunatic for wanting to make a machine to cut grass. Apparently he had to test it at night so that people wouldn't see him and throw stones at him and all the rest of it. There you go. Right, this is the camshaft, and this is the camshaft spindle. And it is very, very important to note, and I'm going to check that this fits anyway first. There's no reason why it shouldn't, but it doesn't. Or does it? Now, this is risky, because if you tap something in, even with a very, very benign hammer like this nylon-headed one, that's all very well, but you can't then easily tap it back out. And there's also a danger that as this goes through, it will create a small burr or a scratch on there that will then stop it passing cleanly through the middle of the camshaft. So I'm a bit reluctant to do it, but the man who took this apart for me keeps telling me it's a lawnmower, meaning it's not the engine out of a high-performance fighter aircraft. Right, this is a little bit one way.